Off the bat, it all depends where you're starting, right? The healthier you are, the more adaptable you are, right? So the healthier you are, the more adaptation you are, more adaptable you are, the more you can deal with a stress like gluten, like sugar, like being off on your diet, like being off on your sleep. So the healthier you are, you may have a little bit more resilience. And then the question comes down to, how do you feel after you eat some crappy food, right? How do you feel? How long does it take you to get back on track the next day? Is it just you're okay and that next day, maybe you're a little bit of a slow starter, but then you're good? Or does it take a couple of days or a whole week to kind of get back on track, right? So the healthier you are, the more adaptation your body has, the more you could cheat a little bit. Now, there's different levels of cheating. There's eating lots of processed sugar and lots of gluten and lots of food allergens that you know you can't handle. Now, if you don't have an autoimmune condition and you aren't as sensitive in regards to how you feel afterwards, you may be able to get away with that every now and then. Not that big of a deal. If you have a diagnosed autoimmune condition like myself, I have Hashimoto's that I have totally managed under control. I always try to choose the healthy alternative, meaning I'm always going to go grain-free over gluten-free. I'm always going to go gluten-free over gluten full, if you will, right? So like we had Thanksgiving last week, we got some squash pies from True Food Kitchen that were 100% grain free and like lower sugar. They were great, right? Good, better, best. So I always try to make the best quality decision I possibly can because I know I have autoimmune issues and I want to prevent my immune system from attacking my body. Now, if someone doesn't have any diagnosed conditions and they feel great, they may be able to do more of an 80-20, kind of 90-10. I do an 80-20, 90-10, but I still keep it to ideally grain-free processed foods or at least gluten-free processed foods. And if someone isn't at a stable place in their health, they're coming to see us, they're in the middle of their functional medicine kind of on-ramp, well, then we got to be a little bit more puritanical off kind of off the bat. So it all depends where you're at in the plan that you're on.
Yeah. And even though I'm feeling better and I could probably get away with more stuff, I just don't go there because I know that I don't want to say it's a slippery slope, but I know that if I'm like, okay, I got away with it once, the next week I may go for it again. And then boom. And then now I've got the skin issue again, or now I've got the gut issue again. So for me, it's very easy to stay on track. I don't feel like I'm missing out. I don't feel deprived. I think one part of this conversation, you're titling this talk is, you know, being healthy, making you anxious or stressed. And I think where people get caught up in it is because they feel like they're deprived. They look at these other people eating the pizza and they're like, well, I want pizza. I'm deprived. This is bull crap. And then they get stressed that they have to eat their grass-fed steak and sweet potato. But for me, once you feel so good, it's not a diet of deprivation. Wouldn't you agree? This is not a diet where you feel like you're missing out. I don't feel like I'm missing out on anything.
Well, anytime you're dealing with, you know, eating a bunch of crappy food, you have to look at why.